Islam, correct me, you're our teacher, that we use our brain, we use the common sense and what's intrinsically in us also to come to this truth, that there's only one God. We worship Him alone, not His creation. And we believe in all the messengers of God, including Jesus, Abraham, Noah, Moses. They all taught the same way of life, Islam, complete and total submission to that one God. And that's how you get peace. So now there are certain tenets of this faith. And one of them is to believe in this unseen world. Now, can we attribute now when people, they talk about the UFOs, unidentified flying objects, they'll even have this paranormal activity going on in some of these, they say haunted houses. They felt like a presence of something, something even by the graveyards. Can we pinpoint it as Muslims that this is the work? Because they'll have films based on a true story, not fiction. These are events, and they bring in like these, you know, Ghostbusters to come in, and they're seeing this paranormal activity. They can't figure it out. Are these the jinn?
Yes, we do. The Prophet, for example, said that the jinn among them who fly, some of these unidentified objects, the flying, it could be the jinn that you see them flying. Also, we know about the jinn that they take, they change forms. They have the ability to change forms. They come in the shape of different objects, can come even in shape of humans, a shape of animals, certain animals. Also, we know that among jinn who lives in houses, they're known as al-awamir, where they live in the house. So many times you might, there is nothing in your house, you might hear something or you feel something walking or a presence of some, you feel certain energy like around you, but you don't see it. And this will be the jinn. For us as Muslim, we know that this is normal. Basically, you live your life. They're not supposed to harm you. They're not supposed to bother you. They have their life and I have my life. And for us, there is extra things, which is the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us there are so many supplications that we do as Muslim in the morning and the night when we enter our home. And when we say it, we'll be protected from such jinn, because the rule goes like this. Allah said in the Quran about the jinn. There's a whole entire chapter in the Quran called jinn, Surah Al-Jinn. وَأَنَّا مِنَّا الصَّالِحُونَ وَمِنَّا دُونَ ذَلِكَ وَكُنَّا طَرَائِقَ قِدَدًا. Among us, the righteous, the good ones, among us, who's not like that, who are nasty, who like to harm people, like what you see in humans. Yeah. Some of them gangs, some of them are, you know.
Same thing on the other side.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Among them, the righteous, the nice one, the good ones, and so forth. So you might come across among one who really would like to harm a person or hurt them, or they hate the righteous people. Sometimes they try to harm them, and the maximum amount of harm that they can do.
Now, my point here is because we'll see, again, paranormal things, unexplained, like a statue will come and there'll be some tears from it. And you'll see like some sounds come out of different idols. And people, they get fascinated with it. Or someone will come and they'll say, in the name of Jesus, or in the name of this person, and then the person's healed. And can it be that this is the jinn working in these situations and deviating people? I heard that sometimes the jinn, they can go into a person and they might have a stiff arm or something. And then someone will pray in the name of, you know, the creation of God, which is only supposed to pray to the creator. And then the jinn comes out and the person is like, wow, this really must be because of who they supplicated in the name of so-and-so.
I'll tell you something historic. It's interesting, similar to this. In the time of the Prophet Muhammad, the people used to go to the idols that they used to worship beside God. And the idol will talk to them. Can you imagine a piece of rock talking?
The idol was
will
talking
talk to them. Yeah. And they said, Muhammad, look, these idols are God. They're talking. They're talking to us. And the Prophet ﷺ proved to them that this is not God. Even if they talk, they don't deserve to be God, because this is not the creator. There is no multiple gods in heavens and earth and all these things. God cannot be in the shape of human. So even if somebody claimed that this is, I call the name of whatever and was healed, does not prove that this is a true, or that human beings can be God, because again, human beings cannot be defined like human. And it could be from the shaitan and his follower, from the jinn. Because one of the Satan's goal, he said to God, I will deviate humans. I will deviate them in any way possible.
That's his main mission.
His main mission.
To make us go astray.
That's why God, and so many times in the Quran said us, he is your enemy, and take him as an enemy. Whoever take him as an ally, whoever will trust him, he will only be among the losers.
That's the shaitan, the devil.
The Satan, devil, which is he's one of the jinn, one of the jinn.
Okay.
And he has so many followers among the jinn themselves. So he has tasks, he sent people to deceive people, deviate people, whisper to people, inspire people to do what is evil and wrong. So that's very possible some of what you see, like you think, oh, this is, that means he's upon the truth. You know what? Magicians use this through across the history. They did this with Moses. They were never upon the truth. Pharaoh was not upon the truth. Truth cannot be recognized by these abnormal things.
Now, we will also hear about seances, where people will come together, some very prestigious people, they'll go to these seances, and they'll do some kind of voodoo, this, that, and the other, and they'll call upon, and they'll see like someone from the past. They'll see their grandfather, or they'll say that someone will speak, they'll hear a voice, and then they end up worshiping what they call spirits.
One of the things that the Satan has, one of his tasks that he appointed for each and every human, one jinn to be in charge of basically deceiving that humans and working on him, inspiring him to do what is evil and bad. And that jinn knows that person very well. So you might come to you in a shape of your father who passed away or some
in the shape of your actual father?
Absolutely. And he comes and he comes like that and he talks to you and you see it. So this is very, very possible. That's very possible. In this case, again, you will see that this is not the way I recognize the truth.
Can they do favors for people? Like, you know, get them thing information. Like the people who do like the you know, the Ouija ball or what's that, the crystal ball, they come in and they tell you certain things and you're blown away. Again, the jinn?
I have a sister came to me and she said, she has this, she said, since I became 13 years old, I was gifted. I have the ability to read cards.
Yeah.
And I can tell you some about your future. I don't know, something, I said, how's that started? I was 13 years old, 14 years old at that time. And he started doing some weird prayers and, you know, spell me. And after that, I was not normal for a while. And after that, I was gifted. That's what she called. And she said, I used to tell the teachers and the people in the school about things related to their life, their homes, what's going to happen to them. Sometimes correct, sometimes not. Then she said, I became Muslim later on. And the moment I became Muslim, she said, this has become a very strong struggle with me. I always feel this energy coming, pressing me. And I had very hard time, headache, like voices in my head and stuff like that. And she asked for my help and advice. She said, when I look at these cards, I will hear certain voices in my ear. And basically, I will tell the person based on the echo of what I heard. But she said, even I was so-called gifted girl, but I never lived a happy life. And my point is that those who the jinn help, they never help them and to give them absolute power. That's why in the history of humanity, everyone used jinn. Look at across the history of every nation in the past who used jinn and magicians. They never ruled the world. They were not the richest people in the world and so forth. So basically, even the jinn offered to help, they enslave that human. They will not just do it for favor or let them go free.
Should people, A, be fearful of jinn? And how could people be protected from those evil jinn harming them?
I'll tell you something, that jinn are afraid of us more than we're afraid of them.
More?
Yes, we are way stronger than jinn. Jinn are very weak creation. You have a shape, you have a body. They don't have that ability that you have, that you, this is your earth, this is your place. No doubt that reading the Quran, prayer, is basically is the best way and form of protection for yourself. And they cannot even come closer to you. I remember I was reading on somebody who possessed with jinn, and that's a true story.
What people would say is an exorcism?
Yes, I witnessed that myself.
What happened? Tell us.
And one of the things that happened, basically after I read on the person and his body was cured of that, the moment we walked out, I heard lash on his back and he jumped about 2 feet in front of me. I immediately run to this guy and uncover his back and I see that mark in his back. I saw how angry they were at him because we free his body from these evil jinn. And later on when he was basically, they come back to him and I read on him, when I asked him, did you the one who hit him? He said, yes. And this is a very strange voice. And he said, why did you do that? He said, I hated, I was so angry. And I said, why you didn't hit me or my friend Adil, which is a person next to me? He said, I wish, but I cannot, because you have did your prayer today, your morning prayer. You've been saying your adhkar, the supplication, the prayer that you do in the day. And I cannot even reach you. I cannot harm you. You are protected. You are strong. Obey the Creator. Pray to Him. Submit yourself to Him. And God said that the plotting of the shaitan is very weak. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, my servant, you have no power over them. And he has no control over you. He cannot harm you.